Gah! I've been doing tech news for 7 years now, and I swear, if I see one more tech story, I'm gonna tell you about it. Gladly! Dealing with pop-ups from antivirus bloatware like McAfee on new laptops is annoying, but if you're involved in the US election, it might actually be dangerous to something other than your own mental health. A new report from Google indicates that a Chinese hacker group dubbed APT31 has been impersonating McAfee employees with the goal of infiltrating computers used by campaign workers. APT31 used phishing tactics to try and get staffers to install McAfee products from GitHub instead of the official McAfee website, which, to be fair, just as sketchy, if not more. And these downloads also contain malware which could be invisible to the end user. Google says this is part of a larger trend of government-backed malware attacks, which have increased as 2020 has gone on. The upcoming presidential election in the US is no doubt a huge impetus for these attacks. And here I was thinking attack ads were the worst part of election season. Ha! Not this year! This is the hell year! Everything's worse!
It's only gonna get worse!
Just you wait! Although the big news recently in the world of wireless charging has been how Apple is bringing back MagSafe, all the wireless charging enthusiasts are talking about it. Don't sleep on Xiaomi! Today they unveiled a wireless charger that can deliver 80 watts, which is more than the power bricks for a lot of mainstream laptops.
That's a lot of watts!
Wow! That's a lot of watts, Marty! Xiaomi claims that its new product can wirelessly charge a 4,000 milliamp hour battery in just 19 minutes, as well as get from 0 to 50 in less than 9 minutes, which would be quite impressive indeed. Although there are faster charging solutions around, this appears to be the fastest wireless one yet, although we're not yet sure exactly when it's going to hit the market. In the meantime, remember to plug your phone in before you pass out, just in case. When it hits the market, and then you're gonna pass out. That's John. We love you, John.
That's our John.
That's our John. If you live in San Francisco, look out for driverless cars tooling around with a bit more regularity. Cruise, which is owned by General Motors, has gotten a permit from the California DMV to put up to 5 driverless cars on the road for use as taxis. In this case, they're Chevy Bolts that have been modified to run autonomously. It's not the first driverless car pilot in the US, but San Francisco's streets are notoriously busy, so it'll be interesting to see how the cars perform. The
test- Look at them go uphill.
They can actually do it! The tests will be limited to just one neighborhood for the time being. Hopefully it's the one with the squiggly, that's insane.
The full house one.
Yeah, exactly. And the cars won't exceed 30 miles per hour to reduce the risk of, you know, a wayward car going careening into.
Step on it, drive, I'm in a hurry.
No word on if and when these trials will expand to the rest of the city or beyond, but it would be awesome not to have to make small talk with an Uber driver. Today's Quick Bits are brought to you by the Corsair iCUE 4000X case. Oh yeah. It has tempered glass front and side panels with dedicated front vent channels for airflow. You also get the iCUE lighting node core for full control and synced RGB lighting for up to 6 fans with Corsair iCUE software.
Yeah!
It comes with 2 Corsair 120mm air guide fans.
Preach.
They utilize vanes to direct airflow and enhance cooling.
See you later.
Click the link below to learn more. Quick Bits, smooth going down. Smooth going up. It looks like we'll be getting the next flagship Galaxy S smartphone a little earlier than anticipated, as leaks indicate it'll be coming in January. Although we're expecting it to again have 3 cameras on the back, it's not clear yet whether it'll be called the S21 or the S30, but I'm sure I'll be calling it expensive. I'm liking these fingers today.
Finger gun.
Finger guy. The iPhone 12 was criticized in some quarters for not offering too many compelling new features, but as the first 5G iPhone, that hasn't stopped it from pulling in pre-orders at more than twice the clip of last year's iPhone 11. Estimates indicate that up to 2 million pre-orders were placed, though that's still only about half of what we saw with the iPhone 6, which we all remember fondly, I guess. That phone famously gave the lineup a larger screen. Maybe Apple just needs to sell an iPhone the size of a TV for pre-orders to really take off. Think about it, Tim Apple. You got the idea here first. A new CPU lineup can often mean needing to buy a new motherboard if you want to upgrade, but MSI has come out and said that all of its 400 series chipset boards will indeed support the new Ryzen 5000 CPUs with a BIOS update, and they're joining Asus in this as well and a few other manufacturers. However, the updated firmware probably won't be ready until January, so I hope you can get through Black Friday as well as Christmas without too much gadget envy. Don't count on it.
What about that gadget every New Year's?
And oddly enough, Tesla looks like it's giving freebies out to a select number of car owners. Some Model 3 owners are getting premium options like satellite maps, live traffic, and streaming music without paying for Tesla's premium connectivity package. It's possible that this might only be available to drivers in Canada. Yes, finally, we get something that the US might be missing out on. I don't want to talk about this anymore. That's our show, so come back Wednesday for more tech news with that tangy tomato flavor you crave. John made a joke about ketchup chips, that's why this was. Hey, don't you throw your really cool stylish shoes at me.
They're not the sponsor.